Hello guys, it's Deep Shah over here, and today I'm going to show you how to create this retro text effect in Photoshop. Also, if you want to learn how to create such cool effects using Photoshop, then hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. So without wasting any time, let's get started. Step over here is we need to create a new document. So for that, go to File and then select New over there. After that, set the width as 1280 pixels, height as 720 pixels, resolution to 300 pixels per inch, and then set the background contents as white, which will fill the layer with white color. After that, click on OK. Now we need to add a nice border over here, which consists of 5 colors. So for that, select Rectangle tool. Then set the stroke as no color. Set the fill to white color. After that, click on the document, which will give you a pop-up for height and width. After that, set the width of the rectangle as 1/5 of the original width of the document. So my original width of the document was 1280 pixels, and dividing it by 5, we get 256 pixels. After that, set the height of the rectangle as original height of the document, which was 720 pixels. And then click on OK. After that, place the rectangle to the left corner of the document using Move tool as follows. After that, we need to fill this rectangle with a nice color. So for that, double click on the icon of the rectangle layer, which will give you a color pop-up. Now over there, set the code of the color as follows: 314357. And then click on OK. So as you can see, there is a white line outside of the rectangle over here. So now in order to hide that line, go to View and then click on Show over there. After that, untick the target path option over there. So as you can see, the white line has been gone. After that, create a duplicate of this rectangle by pressing Ctrl plus J and then press Shift and move it to the sidewards. After that, using the left arrow key of your keyboard, make both the edges of the rectangle touch. Now after that, click on the icon of the second rectangle icon over here and then set the code for the rectangle as follows: 456672. Now again create a duplicate of the rectangle, place it properly using Move tool. Then double click on the icon of the rectangle layer and then set the color code for the rectangle as follows: 6C9575. After that, again create a duplicate of the rectangle, place it properly using Move tool, double click on the icon of the rectangle layer and then set the code for the rectangle color as follows: E3B 587, and then click on OK. Now again create a duplicate of the rectangle by pressing Ctrl plus J, place it properly using Move tool, double click on the icon of the rectangle layer, then set the color code as follows: C98C70, and then click on OK. So now we have the color palette ready over here, which will be useful for our frame as well as for the font colors. So now we need to merge all the rectangle layers into a single group. So for that, press Shift and click on the first rectangle layer, which will give you the selection of two layers as well as all the layers in between. After that, press Ctrl plus G to merge all the layers into a single group. Now you can rename the group as Borders. After that, again select Rectangle tool and then set the fill of the rectangle as white, set the stroke as no color, and then click on the document, which will give you a pop-up for height and width. Now set the width of the rectangle as 20 minus the original width of the document, which will be 1260 pixels. Height also 20 minus the original height of the document, which will be 700 pixels. And then click on OK. Now we need to place this rectangle at the center of the document. So for that, press Ctrl and click on the background layer over here, which will give you the selection of background layer as well as keep the selection of the rectangle layer. Then select Move tool. After that, click on Align Vertical Centers, and then click on Align Horizontal Centers. So as you can see, the rectangle has been placed properly and we have a nice frame surrounding the rectangle over here. Now we need to change the color for the rectangle. So for that, double click on the icon of the rectangle layer and then set the color code for the rectangle as follows: E9, E2, C7, and then click on OK. So now we have the background ready and the frame ready. Now we need to place the text over here. So for that, select horizontal type tool. After that, select any font of your choice. The download link for the font I'm choosing is in the description below. Also, if you don't know how to download font in Photoshop, link for that is in the description as well. After that, set the size of the font accordingly. And then set the color of the font as accordingly. After that, create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon. And then click on the document and then type in the letters of your text. After that, click on this tick icon to place it. After that, press Ctrl plus T and then rotate the text a little bit. I'm rotating it by minus 5 degrees. And then click on this tick icon to place it. Now we need to place this text at the center of the document. So for that, press Ctrl and click on the background layer, which will give you the selection of background layer as well as keep the selection of the text layer. Then select Move tool and then click on Align Vertical Centers and then click on Align Horizontal Centers. So as you can see, the text has been placed properly at the center of the document. After that, make the text layer active by clicking on it and then click on Add Layer Style icon and then select Blending options over there. After that, click on Drop Shadow and then set the blend mode of the drop shadow to normal. Set the color as one of the color from frame using the picker tool and then click on OK. After that, set the opacity as 100%, set the angle as 120 degree and make sure that the use global light option has been checked. After that, set the distance to 5 pixels. Set the spread to 100%. Set the size as 10 pixels. And then click on OK. After that, create the duplicate of the text layer by pressing Ctrl plus J. And now bring the duplicate layer below the original text layer. After that, click on the drop shadow option of the duplicate layer. And then set the color of the duplicate layer as the next color of the frame. Keep the angle to 120 degree, opacity to 100%. Change the distance to 15 pixels. Keep the spread as 100% and size as 10 pixels. After that, click on OK. Now again create a duplicate of the text layer by pressing Ctrl plus J. Now bring the duplicate text layer at the bottom of the text layers. Then click on the icon of the drop shadow. Then set the color of the drop shadow as the third color from the frame. Then change the distance of the drop shadow to 25 pixels. And then keep rest all things same and then click on OK. After that, again create a duplicate of the text layer by pressing Ctrl plus J. Now bring the duplicate text layer at the bottom of the text layers. Then click on the drop shadow option over here. Then set the color of the drop shadow as the fourth color from the frame. Then change the distance of the drop shadow to 35 pixels and keep rest of the things same. After that, click on OK. Now again create a duplicate of this layer by pressing Ctrl plus J. Bring the text layer below at the bottom of the text layers. After that, click on the drop shadow option. And then set the color of the drop shadow as the fifth color from the frame. Then set the distance to 45 pixels. And keep the rest all things same. After that, click on OK. So now as you can see, we have the vintage text effect ready over here. But to make it look more better, I'm going to do one more thing. So for that, press Shift and click on the first text layer, which will give you the selection of that text layer as well as give you the selection of all the text layers in between. After that, press Ctrl plus G to merge all the text layers into a single group. After that, bring in any vintage texture image over here. Download link for the vintage texture I am using is in the description below. After that, scale that image so that it fits the document properly. While scaling, press Shift to scale evenly. After that, click on this tick icon to place it. Now bring this vintage texture layer below the text group layer. After that, change the blend mode of the vintage texture layer to multiply. And then reduce the opacity of the layer to 20%. After that, make the text group layer active by clicking on it. And then click on add layer style icon and then select blending options over there. Now click on the blending option custom options over here. And then move the white underlying slider towards left. So this will blend the text more properly with the background. After that, press Alt and click on the slider, which will break the slider into two, and then drag the left portion of the slider more towards left, and then drag the right portion of the slider more towards right. After that, click on OK. So as you can see, the text has been blended properly with the background. So that's it guys, this will give you your retro text effect in Photoshop. Now if you guys like this video, then hit the like button, also share it to the ones who might be interested in such videos, and subscribe to the channel for more videos in Photoshop. Thanks for watching, bye bye.